Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynuts and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series. We're still in the office of the late Julie Langford, who was killed by Andrew Ryan, in a, well, gas room, which is actually kind of historically creepy. I hacked the UN vent in the meantime, and as you can see, we can now create the Lazarus vector in the UN vent, which requires 6 bits of distilled water, 6 samples of bee spit, and 6 times chlorophyll solution, of which we already have 5. So I wasn't sure if he remembered that I actually found a few already, but he does. So let's take one of these and throw that in the first thing we come across. Especially, well, right over there. Goodbye. So those guys just died horribly, because there was another explosive barrel over there as well, so interestingly enough. I don't think there are any little sisters left. So the one thing we need to be careful about is that, as you can hear, the security system is back online. So the Big Daddy won't harm us, but the camera here in the middle will, and that turret of course as well. I'm just gonna keep. There we go, because we can hack those immediately right now. And then I'm gonna just position myself underneath the camera, take a few nice pictures of that camera, and we have increased damage for some reason. Not that we're gonna damage the camera. There we go. So now we're gonna have to systematically take over the security system for ourselves. I think there's another turret in the next room, and there's a Houdini splicer. If I only knew where he went. Because he teleported and then teleported away. We can sink if you know. Okay, apparently that didn't work. There we go, increased damage. Damn it. Oh, dead, stop shooting at me. Thanks for killing it though. So there we have the chlorophyll solution found. It says 6 out of 7, but I think the Lazarus vector recipe told us to. Oh. So there we go, let's take a few pictures. And hack it. And I think that's pretty much it. So, if the need arises, we have all this. These security devices at our disposal. I think I'd like a few more Eve hypos. There we go. That fills that up nicely. And now we need to go out and find the other items. Only the chlorophyll solution is found in these areas. So there we have another chlorophyll solution, the last one. So that completes that, because there is a lot more chlorophyll solution than we actually need in this place. So next up is the farmer's market. Mostly rural. If you're looking for something in particular, I'd start at the farmer's market. I think we were already that far, Atlas, but thanks anyway. So we still need to go out there eventually, but this place is in lockdown because of the, well, the dead tree problem. I don't think, no. Just looking around a bit to see if we didn't miss any items, because I think we missed a few over there. So there we go, let's use telekinesis, because I don't think we can actually access that from there. I dropped that for some reason, but there we go. There we go.
Sound City built to not let anyone out in the event of this kind of emergency. Either we get those trees back, or you're a permanent resident.
A permanent resident, a permanent dead resident, probably. So let's head to the farmer's. Oh, there we go. There's a lot of items just hidden around the higher areas where you just can't reach them. So let's go with Electrobolt. And then over here is the transit station leading towards the farmer's market. But I'm going to have to be careful here, because as you can see, there's a lot of trouble here. So let's take him out quickly. So I think I can't... Oh, I can't take pictures if it's just disabled. So let's hack it. There we go, our own little buddy. We're also running low on film, so next time we can buy that, I'm gonna do so. This is a pretty big open area, but I don't think there's that much going on here. Arcadia and oxygen, though, that might be interesting. Okay, let's listen to it, thank you.
Now I'm a woman of science, but I'm also a woman who's not afraid of turning a buck or two. Ryan said if I could boost profits in Arcadia, part of the app would ride on my hip. So I get to thinking, we're paying for oxygen when we got photosynthesizing trees. Hell, we can even sell the extra to the rest of the city and undercut the other guys. Ryan will like that for sure. Fontaine's people have moved into the O2 biz tooth and claw.
So, because of obvious reasons, oxygen is a big business in Rapture. Because, well, everybody needs it. But Julie Langford was partly responsible for taking away a lot of business from Fontaine. Which might start you, let you start thinking, right? So there we have another fire. And a burning splicer who doesn't make a lot of noise. Apparently I would be screaming in agony! And there we have something a bit more interesting. Look at that. Another power of the people's power to the people station. These are actually created by Fontaine Futuristics, so by Frank Fontaine himself. But let's upgrade another weapon. I think the one we've been using most is gonna be either the machine gun or the shotgun. The other really interesting one is the consumption rate for the chemical thrower. Which I'm wondering for... I like the shotgun, so we'll start out with that. So the damage increase for the shotgun. Damage increase? I'm sounding like Sean Connery. That was maybe a bit too much. I think this just leads back to where we came from, yeah, but I'm seeing another Eve hypo and I can't resist. So this is the upper area where we've been already. So here we fought those two big daddies. But over here we could get back to the tree farm. I must be careful with going in and out of areas, because as I've told you before, that just respawns enemies. So that guy's dead. He was burned alive by those lovely Houdini splicers. So that's what that war is still going on. But we of course need to be careful that we don't get the same fate as those two burning guys. But first, let's hack this thing. There we go. And of course, let's buy some more film. There we go. We can't buy that electric gel here, but I'm gonna do that as soon as we can. So that's a bit more of our money spent, because we have a lot. So actually, just let's fill up a bit more. There we go. Quite nicely, because we have a lot of money. Oh, hello. Goodbye. That was actually pretty... I like tossing stuff around with telekinesis. I mean, you probably noticed that already, but... It's just so much fun to just throw something in someone's face and watching him explode just like that. So the fire is actually linked to the Houdini splices themselves, because when I killed that splicer, the fire just stopped for some reason. Which is actually pretty weird, but hey. So let's open the safe with an auto hack. Maybe there's an auto hack inside. No, yeah, of course. So now we got two first aid kits. So I'm gonna just heal up and get one of those. I don't think there's anything else in these shacks except for these pep bars, but we don't really need those. Anything underneath here? No! Oh, that didn't go through. Yes, indeed. Maternal instinct. What could that be about?
What makes something like me? I look at genes all day long, and never do I see the blueprint of sin. I could blame the Germans, but in truth, I did not find tormentors in the prison camp, but kindred spirits. these children I brutalized have awakened something inside that for most is beautiful and natural. But in me is an abomination. My maternal instinct.
So, in a pretty weird way, Tannenbaum actually still cares for the little girls she brutalized, as she puts it herself. Maybe I'm gonna go into that a bit more. So what she did to the little sisters is actually implant those slugs that produced Adam inside of a little sister. Well, into a little girl, which turns them into a little sister, which makes them practically invincible, but also turns them into those ghoulish little things we've been seeing around. The way they extract Adam from corpses is, if we would have seen one doing it already, is they extract the blood out of a corpse using the syringe they're carrying, and then they suck, well, they drink the blood, and their body filters out the Adam from the blood. Which also indicates that for a little sister to be effective towards the industry here, so that it would give back the Adam, they would need to harvest it the same way we can. So practically killing it. Which isn't really nice now, is it? So they practically were dooming these little girls. There we have another flashback. To their death. But let's go to the farmer's market and I'll see you guys there. So, Arcadia, the main bit of Arcadia is actually responsible for growing crops and actually providing food aside from the oxygen as well. And the farmer's market is of course used to sell those crops, which should allow us to find that distilled water we need and the bee spit. And look at that, there's actually trees and cages over there, inside of the, well, outside in the water, which produce more oxygen. Those look still fine, so we're not dying just yet, but eventually the oxygen would run out because there's not enough to go around. So there's one enzyme sample and another diary about
Julie,
bee
dear, enzyme. I'm gonna have to start charging you for the pleasure. If I come out one more time and find you lolling out there amongst my hives, I'm grabbing my shotgun. As to your question, yes, my days in beekeeping school are a blur, but I do seem to remember something about that enzyme you keep blabbing on about.
So they apparently also succeeded in keeping bees here, which is good for us because we need the bee enzyme, and for some reason we need one extra of everything. Because we need 7 enzyme samples as well. So, Julie Langford already tried to get into the bees, but she was gonna get charged for it, so she probably stopped that avenue because of the money issue. And we have more music! There we go. So there's a... Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck was that? I think the Houdini Spicer just teleported inside of my body. That was fucking creepy. Okay. I honestly think there's a rocket turret on the right there. Because, well, she got blown to bits. So there's another splicer over there behind the counter. But I think I can... take this thing first. There we go. Another level. Increased damage. And I don't think... Yeah. So we've done researching turrets. I think I just heard something go off. Yeah, he's firing at the splicer over there now. Which is fine by me. Just kill the bitch. Where's the camera? Oh yeah, over there. Yeah, it's a bit blurry because I'm equipped with the camera. Let's hack it. There we go. My camera. My lovely camera. The annoying thing, well, annoying. The annoying thing about this place is that it's actually filled with loot. There's a lot of little cabinets all over the place. So this might get a bit loot heavy. But I'm going to try to keep that to a minimum. And do that during the audio diaries, by the way.
Children, with their very long needles, their tombless songs, their ghastly errands, their ghoulish Frankenstein fathers. But we've all placed our hand on the great chain of endeavor. My hand is on it. Fontaine's is on it. We all pull it and are pulled by it. Yes, these children are an abomination. But it is not my hand alone on the chain that created them. No. Their little fingers were right there, next to mine.
So Andrew Ryan is struggling with his conscience, what he did with the little sisters, and tries to justify it by just saying that they were in for it the moment they entered the Rapture. There we go. And as you can see, since this is a separate area, there are still little sisters left. So I think they're currently fighting a Houdini splicer. Yeah, he's still on fire. So might as well take advantage of the opportunity here. And do that. Just gonna wait and see. So we boosted the shotgun, and as you can see, that actually did a lot. And just plainly killed it. Holy shit, that was fast. So the explosives combined with a few electric bugs in the turret that took its attention kind of made that easy. So there we go. The only little sister in this area, I think, if I check, yeah, there's only one little sister here. I am doubting whether to... did I actually take a picture of you? I need to take pictures. I know this sounds weird, but I need to take pictures. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so I didn't take pictures of the Big Daddy, but there's enough rosies to go around, but only limited little sisters. So now we're at the maximum of our money, actually. We can't get anything else. So let's auto-hack the save. And see, 100 liquid nitrogen, 4 frag grenades, and anti-personnel rounds. I didn't even need that first aid kit, which is really, really interesting. I can hear another camera around here. So there's more, well, our first bit of distilled water. And let's listen to water in the wine.
10 years in this dump, I've come to accept a very low standard of life. But even at the bottom of this fish tank, a man must have standards. The pathetic trou de cul done at Morley Winery I started putting water to his terrible wine. Water! When I confront him with this fatty, he tells me, Pierre, this is not to worry. The water, she is distilled. It could be worse. I could take it right from the ocean.
So, the Frenchman we just listened to was a bit angry because his partner put water into his wine. And he told him not to worry, because he could have been doing it with ocean water. But that just indicates that we can find a lot of distilled water in the winery, which we will in a minute. But let's just hack this thing first. There we go. There's another crawl space here as well, with a ominously hung corpse for some reason. But apparently there's nothing here except for the dead guys. Well, there's more than one, apparently. I don't know if I actually ever found this room. There's another vent over there, but I can't go in there. We need to come from the other way. That's actually pretty gruesome. I don't think I ever found that room. So new things for me as well, even though I completed this game probably about 6 times. Let's see, the tag this thing is... Whoa!
Come here, you!
A shovel splicer. Why is he on fire? That doesn't look healthy. So another big area, so let's hack this first. There we go. Let's see if we can buy anything, because we're running out of money space. So let's buy a lot of film. Let's fill that up. And let's buy these as well, and we only spent about 100... bucks, which is sad for some reason. So let's head into the winery. I'm kind of trying to find my bearings here. So this is where we killed the Big Daddy. So that's the main area. We're going to come back to that later on. So let's head into the winery first. The Whirly Winery. No, Whirly Winery. Okay, so we need to go outside for that. I always love these little vistas. Well, little, but not really little. So we can go to the Whirly Winery over there, or we can go to the Silverwing Apiary. So those are the bees. Those are the distilled water bits. So let's head here first. Whirly Winery. And there's two corpses on the ground here. I don't think we get ambushed right away.
Why do they wear those masks? Maybe there's a part of them that remembers how they used to be, how they used to look. And they're ashamed.
So Atlas 2 cents about the fact that some splashers wear masks. Like these guys. So now we have a splicer pretty close by. We can also hear a camera, but he's pointing in the wrong direction. Oh shit, that was not what I intended to do. Because I know I can just hack them immediately. So let's do that. I think there's two cameras actually. That was the noise of two cameras. So there's one over here next to the wall. So there we go. Flow speed reduced when hacking any security camera. Which is not as good as instantly hacking it, but hey. There we go. That made it actually pretty easy. We're starting to be able to hack pretty much everything. So let's also hack the safe again. Our last automatic hack tool, apparently. Two distilled water, so that's great. So we already found 3 out of 7. And we're, again, at the maximum amount of money we can carry. So let's hack this thing. There we go. Health station for us. And I don't think there's anything else behind this counter. What's this? Probably bullet holes. If I'm not mistaken, I think there's a Houdini splicer around here somewhere. This one's dead. We haven't actually had a corpse that stood up again yet. Some more distilled water. Yeah, so yeah, this is actually the place we need to be in for the distilled water. Let's take a look around, because I think there's a lot of audio diaries here as well. Okay. Functional children!
I find being around them very uncomfortable. Even with those things implanted in their bellies, they are still children. They play and sing. Sometimes they look at me and they don't stop. Sometimes they smile.
So kind of contradicting the previous one from Tannenbaum, she's actually put off a bit by the children as well because of what she did to them. Because she actually would have preferred them to be in a vegetative state, but that was not working with well, for their goals to produce atoms. So let's hack this vending machine. There we go, let's see. Yeah, we're really getting filled up here. So that's actually a bit of the stupid thing I find with Bioshock 1. The one problem I have with it is that it gets progressively easier the further we go. Because we're at, well, aside from one, the highest difficulty. More distilled water. And we're actually flying through these enemies. Is there? I don't see him. I'm going to take this corpse over here. Thank you. And just use that to take away the electricity. Just so when we run back for some reason, we don't get smashed in the face. Oh, that's always so funny. I mean, come on. That's just hilarious. Can you come get me? I think there's one on the right. Oh, shit. Hi. Okay. So there's a Big Daddy and a splicer over there. Which is a bit annoying if I miss my electrobolt.
Is this good enough for you?
Yeah. You know what? Try to accidentally hit the... God damn it. I'm just gonna whack you. Thank you. So that put a bit of a drain on my resources, which isn't bad. Let's search all these guys. There's more distilled water here. Armor piercing rounds, and we could hack the UN vent, but right now I don't think there's actually much use for it. So we only need one more piece of distilled water. I'm actually pretty turned around right now. So we came from over here, because I don't want to really miss anything. So this guy we killed. Empty hypo. Because there's a lot of nooks and crannies in the winery here that I don't really want to miss. Yeah. Fuck off. So, Sport Boost 2. Tired of being outrun by your neighbor with Sport Boost installed? Get new Sport Boost 2 and outrun him. So, move even faster. There we go. So we're getting pretty strong with that as well. And that's the all the distilled water, because there's actually a lot more of these things than we actually need, because we haven't even been to the basement yet. This guy looks pretty dead. I think he kind of committed suicide here. Put the shotgun to his chin and fired. Hi. Hi. Can you see me? No, you can't. He is strong. So that's a UN vent. There's a big daddy. Let's take some pictures. Pictures. You like pictures? Yeah, okay. Let's go out of his way and go downstairs.
Why have you forsaken?
I don't know.
I send you.
Is he carrying a gun or not? Oh, it's a Houdini splicer. Never mind. Hi. Because yeah, by like standing in front of their face, just taking pictures. Just taking pictures. And here we have another one. Another power to the people station. So let's rise to the occasion. So machine gun damage or chemical thrower consumption. I think I'm going to go for the machine gun damage. I like it with the anti-personnel rounds. So that should allow us to take out splices even quicker. So there's a lot of nooks and crannies here, as you can see. I'm gonna try and do this in a bit more of a structured way. So we found that. Now we have the camera over there. So let's take our camera as well. And let's just take some pictures. And let's hack it. There we go. So we don't need to take care of anything else. So let's start using a few of our fancier things. Let's equip the shotgun. And I think I never fired it once with the exploding box equipped, so this might be a nice way of doing that. There's water over here, so it might not be the best way of using the exploding box. I think, yeah, there's a tonic over there. So that's not really an issue. Although there is something really cool that happens here. So let's take Photographer's Eye. That's the original one. We already got level 2, so we're not going to use it. And then we hear a lot of screaming behind us. And if we turn around, this happens. That's annoying. But not something we can't do anything about. Because we're kind of a fish in a barrel right now. So there we go. And now, of course, we're going to add insult to injury and take one of their corpses and use that for that. And I think this is, yeah, there's a director's commentary. So thank you for that. Let's see here. Napalm. More distilled water we can't really use. And, well, that's about it for this room, I think. The music turned around a bit because of the fact that we just got trapped. And there's a lot of dead cats. We found one in the previous episode as well. But I don't know what's the big deal with Rapture and dead cats. Because they like to throw them around a bit. I don't think there's anybody here. As you can see, there's plenty of distilled water. But I think we can use that in other recipes as well later on. So, that's pretty much it, I think. I don't think there was another area over here, but I think we've seen everything there. Oh no, wait, we haven't. I'm wrong, I'm dead wrong. So more distilled water. So yeah, I think there's about three times as much as you actually need around this place, because there's two more over there. This one died. I don't even know it's worth hacking. I'm just gonna whack it and take the first aid kit. Let's see, I think there's another audio diary around here somewhere, talking a bit more about the winery itself. Or I'm just completely mistaken again. I thought there was. So let's wait with that. I thought there was in this room. But I must be wrong. I clearly must be wrong. Never mind then. Let's head over here. Not that I think there's anything that loops around again. Okay. So that's about it. So let's head back upstairs. Hello. Excuse me. Oh, hi.
Yeah, run!
Goodbye. So yeah, he didn't even hit me. So let's head back outside and try to find those B enzymes we need. So this just looks down on the area we were trapped in. And if we go back upstairs, I think we're getting ambushed by another one. Or not. I thought there was... Oh, yeah, there we go. I knew it. I just plainly knew it. Easier to predict Houdini splicer teleportation destination. There we go. So the one-two punch still works! And, yeah, he... Oh, yeah, an enemy triggered you. I was already thinking, oh my god, where's the camera? But... apparently that's not bad, so let's head into here. So let's take the opportunity, because this guy is dying! Yeah, fuck off, beast. So, we're in the apiary, clearly. And there's another Gatherer's Garden, which I might take a look at. The most interesting ones here are Insect Swarm, which is another plasmid, which I am going to use. Nothing clears a room like swarms of stinging hornets. Warning, not recommended for users with allergies, like me, by the way. So you know a bit more about me right now, so let's swap target dummy out for insect swarm.
Unleash insects against groups of enemies. Attack lots of enemies at the same time.
So that's that, and the really cool thing about that is something I'm going to show you in a minute. I think I'm going to add... I'm doubting to do it, but... let's add one engineering slot, and just pick one. Reduces difficulty when hacking turrets, bots, and cameras. Two fewer overload tiles is probably the most interesting one. So two fewer overload tiles, that should help us out. And that's about it. Because I don't want to use... reducing the prices is useless at this point, because we have more money than we can spend. Extra health from snacks is pretty useless. And we try to overtake cameras, bolts, and turrets instead of destroying them. So not really useful. But Insect Swarm is cool just because how your hand looks. I mean, look at that. It's just fucking disgusting. I'm quickly gonna pick up this one as well, because this one is titled Adam Explained.
Adam acts like a benign cancer, destroying native cells and replacing them with unstable stem versions. While this very instability is what gives it its amazing properties, it is also what causes the cosmetic and mental damage. You need more and more Adam just to keep back the tide. From a medical standpoint, this is catastrophic. From a business standpoint, well, Fontaine sees the possibilities.
So Tenenbaum has a bit of a bad side, as we already knew, but she goes into bed with Fontaine, well, not literally, but financially, and, well, she just explained why Adam is so, is just as much addicting as any other drug, which causes the craziness in the splicers. And now we have the apiary, which is a pretty interesting room, but I'm gonna have to leave that for the next episode. So thank you guys enormously for watching. I'm gonna take a little break, and when we come back, we're gonna go inside of there. But thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.